Wishbone Gold has told investors it's hit its target of shifting 25 kilos a week in December, as demand for the precious metal remains strong in the wake of Donald Trump's presidential victory. Chief Executive Richard Poulden is on the line with me. Richard, good morning to you.
Good morning, Andrew.
Richard, sounds like you're making good progress here with trading. How would you describe business in 2016, first of all?
Well, I would say it's been very good. We only really started this business halfway through the year. We set up a borrowing facility in June to fund the trading business, and it's built up to our objective of shipping 25 kilos a week by the year end. So I'm well pleased, as I said in the RNS, I think it's a transformative and successful year for Wishbone.
Successful year for you. Do you reckon across the board gold trading's a good business to be in at the moment?
Well, Andrew, I think gold is a good business to be in. And I know I've been saying this for a number of years in my Black Swan economic newsletters, but I think that the gold price, as I've said elsewhere, is manipulated, much the same way as LIBOR was, much the same way as the Forex markets were. And we can see at the moment that there are very substantial volumes of gold moving east into India and China. India is, again, in 2016, the largest purchaser in the world, which is a position it took over from China in 2015. And they are building up very, very substantial gold positions at these prices. And I think that gold remains a good investment in very uncertain economic times.
And you reckon that position could sustain itself through 2017?
Position of gold being a good investment?
Absolutely.
Yes, I do. And I think at these levels, it has a long way to go.
Richard, where do you see opportunities for you in 2017?
Well, we sort of hinted at that in the RNS, because what we've started to do in 2016 is, in a fairly gentle fashion, reverse integrate up the supply chains for the trading. We've been discussing doing that in South America. We've done it in Ghana, and we're looking at doing that to a greater extent in 2017. Now, the effect of that is low-level investment, just a little bit of equipment here and there, but that locks in the suppliers into our supply chain, and that, I think, is quite important.
Looking 12 months down the track, Richard, where would you like to be? What would you have liked to have achieved?
Oh, world domination, Andrew, without a question. Isn't that what everyone wants to achieve in the small cap market? No, seriously, what I would expect to do by the end of 2017 is I want our trading volumes substantially increased. And I want to be in a situation where we've brought to fruition several of the reverse integration strategies that we're pursuing at the moment. Now, we can't, as always, announce anything until it's completely done and dusted. But as soon as we can announce any progress in those areas, then we will do so.
Well, Richard, you're certainly painting an exciting year ahead for Wishbone. What would you say to investors considering investing in Wishbone?
I didn't think I was allowed to push my own stock beyond what I've said, Andrew. I mean, I'm a buyer. That's clearly out there in the market. I think that the company has a great future. And anyone that goes back through the way we run Wishbone, where the directors are paid in shares, all of the directors have invested substantial amounts of money, me most of all, you can go back and look through the public domain. We very much put our money where our mouths are on this one.
Very good to speak to you, Richard. All the very best. Thanks very much.
Many thanks for your time, Andrew. Appreciate it.